A lot of teams don't achieve the results that they could, and others perform poorly. And I want to change that. That is why I will share 8 conditions that are crucial for a great team. You do not want to miss this. Hi, I'm Minfred, and I'm sure that you want to lead your team to more success. But a lot of teams don't reach their full potential. This is often caused by a lack of trust, fear of confrontation, lack of commitment, avoiding responsibility, or an unhealthy workload. As a leader, it's your job to create the right circumstances for a good atmosphere within your team. You accomplish that by fulfilling these 8 conditions: teamwork, common goals, trust, room for discussion and conflict, recognition and rewards, attention for individual contributions, room for innovation, and a good workload. Now I can hear you think, yes, Winfred, that is pretty obvious. But think about it a little longer. Do you really check all the boxes? If you have even the shred of doubt, you should watch the remainder of this video. Let's start with the first condition, teamwork. It seems too easy to be the first condition, but the success of your team is depending on it. Of course, you can have a group of good individuals that do their work to the best of their ability, but that will never be as successful as a team that works together. Being a team needs work every day. It demands commitment, time, and effort from you and your team members. Be aware of that. Create involvement with each other, with the team, and with the process. This will create a base of success for your team. Your team needs a clear vision of the future, combined with smart goals set within a realistic framework. You have to make sure that everyone understands the individual roles and tasks within the team and the behavior that comes with it. As a leader, you need to provide this to your team. It is a good idea to involve your team by setting the goals, creating the framework, and dividing roles and tasks. It will create great commitment within the team. Trust is essential for a successful team. First of all, you and your team members need to trust individual team members to execute their task to the best of their abilities. But beside that, trust creates a situation where your team members can show vulnerability. They can easily ask for help when they have too much to do or when they make a mistake. Trust is a difficult thing. You can't force anyone to trust. It needs to be earned. And moreover, it is fragile and easy to lose. Every team member can contribute to building trust within your team with an open and vulnerable attitude. Stimulate your team members to ask for help, to admit that they did something wrong, and that they need feedback to improve their skills. Here you can lead by example. You can stimulate team members through individual meetings and team meetings. And once they start trusting each other, it will be contagious. When trust is established within your team, it opens possibilities for open discussions. A great team will always have lively team meetings because every team member dares to express their opinion. So when it stays quiet during your team meetings, it is time to work on the trust levels within your team. When your team meetings are lively and full of discussion, it is only a matter of time before it ends in conflict. And that is not a bad thing, as long as the conflict focuses on improving the results of your team. A discussion sometimes needs to heat up to stimulate great ideas. Of course, these heated discussions can only lead to good results when there is enough mutual trust between your team members. Otherwise, I am sure that a part of your team will withdraw from the discussion because of self-preservation. When a heated discussion leads to a decision, it is most probable that it will be realized. Your team will be much more committed to this decision than to a decision that was made during a quiet meeting. It all has to do with the active involvement of your team members. You want your team to be focused on achieving the set goals. You have already ensured that your team is committed to those common goals. To keep them motivated to work on those goals together, it is important to recognize and reward the results. And by that, I do not mean the individual results. Most managers and organizations only focus on the individual team members. And to be honest, this does not stimulate your team effort. It will cause inequality and distrust within your team. And of course, your team members will mainly focus on their individual results. So stop with individual rewards and start with team rewards. They will stimulate your team to achieve the goals together. They will support and help each other. And that will lift your team to a whole new level. Once you get the focus on teamwork, the individual contributions can get lost within the team. But it is important to show the individual contributions to the rest of the team. This will grow appreciation between team members. At the same time, it's a great way to keep track of individual performance. Team meetings are a good place to stimulate individual team members to share their contribution with the team. With the team rewards in mind, your team will exchange knowledge and experiences that will improve their skills and performance. It is up to you as a leader to lead the meeting in a way that your team members will share knowledge and feedback in a positive manner. When you succeed, your team members will be even more committed and they will take their responsibility in realizing the common goals. Through time, your team needs to learn, adapt, and improve. Innovation is crucial to realize your long-term goals. The first thing your team needs for innovation is reflection and awareness. During and after each project, they need to evaluate together to discover what they could do better next time. The second thing that you should do is look at the processes within your organization or department regularly. Together, you will discover bottlenecks and opportunities in no time. And third, you need to take risks. Calculated risks. Try new things that are allowed to fail. It will give great opportunity to learn and to grow. Your team will never become great if you don't dare to take risks now and then. Many good teams and great projects fail because of an impossible workload. When you have a great team, your team members will share their workload when it is needed. While your team members have each other's back, you must have theirs. It is your task as a leader to control that workload. You and your team can't always be overloaded with work. It is unhealthy, and it will prevent good teamwork, good feedback, and the possibility of innovation. Okay, let's go over these 8 conditions one more time. Teamwork, common goals, trust, room for discussion and conflict, recognition and rewards, attention for individual contributions, room for innovation, and a good workload. When you keep working on these conditions, I am sure that you will create a great team. The results will even be better when you use the right style of leadership in the right situation. When you want to know more about that, you should watch this video about the 6 leadership styles you must master. Great, we are done for today. Be sure to let me know in the comments when you think there is a 9th or a 10th condition that I should have mentioned. Maybe I will make another video about it. Thanks for watching, and I hope I will see you soon in another video. Bye!